What is going on, everyone? Today we are talking about what exactly it takes to become a citizen of a node, along with the pros and cons to becoming a citizen. So let's jump right into it. As you set out to make your home in the world of Vera, you will look to find an environment that fits your playstyle. Whether that means being a player that is a master of economy or seeking out wars and conquering castles, citizenship within a node is something that will help you along in this journey. There are four different types of nodes, which mean four different potential cities to call your home: divine nodes, economic nodes, military nodes, and scientific nodes. Personally, I'll be heading to an economic node to help my crafting skills thrive, but once you decide and the node reaches the village stage or stage 3, you will be able to head to that node and purchase a home. Whether that be an instanced or non-instanced house is up to you, as long as non-instanced are available, but no matter what you choose, once you make the big purchase, you will gain citizenship of that node. That's all it takes. There isn't any other way to become a citizen, but as the testing goes on, this could change, as they have talked about the possibility for citizenship tickets to be available if enough feedback is given and players don't like how it currently works. But anyways, make your choice carefully, as you can only be a citizen of one node at a time, and one citizenship is available per account per server. Node citizenship is not tied to guilds either, as guilds do not own nodes. It will take a lot more than one guild to establish dominance in a node, so essentially you could be a citizen of the same node as a rival guild. But don't worry too much, because if the enemy guild picks on you too much, you can sell your home and buy a new one elsewhere to become a citizen of a different node. But citizenship will require a 2-week cooldown, which could change with testing, but I personally don't expect it to go down, because this prevents players from constantly jumping around trying to cheat the system. You will also lose your citizenship if that node is destroyed, but it is unknown if this would reset the 2-week cooldown for you. If you're set in your ways of being a lone wolf and decide you don't need no citizenship to make you happy, well, you can do so, and by doing this you won't have to pay taxes to any of the nodes like all of those other citizens do. But you will also be missing out on all of the benefits that come with becoming a citizen, such as titles, reputation, honor, loyalty, merit, and participation in the node government. Meaning, citizens are allowed to vote and allowed to run for governor. So if you want a bigger say in the direction of a node, then you'll want to make sure that you are a citizen, as your vote could drive the node to success or failure. What are your thoughts on this quick rundown of citizenship in Ashes of Creation? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you have yet to make an Ashes account, do jump in on the forums or purchase some cosmetic skins, or just because you want to have an Ashes of Creation account because it's the closest thing you can have to playing the game right now, well then feel free to use my referral link in the description below. Otherwise, be sure to click that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, turn on the bell for notifications, and stay tuned for a lot more to come.